I guess you are watching this video because your computer is running with an issue here as you are trying to open a program you have recently installed. This error arrived. The program can start because MSVCP140.dll is missing from your computer, or the code execution cannot proceed because MSVCP140.dll was not found. These are the exact same problem and it has the same solution as well. Hello everyone, welcome to Tech Evolution. In this very short video, I'll be fixing this error. Let me thank you for your really nice comments in my previous video. Consider subscribing to the channel if the video helps you. So, don't forget to like and subscribe. So, let's get started. The first step is to download the DLL file and place it. In order to do that, you need to first open your favorite browser and go to Google and search for MSVCP140.dll. You can choose any result you want. Let's choose the first one. I'll put the link in the description if you need, you can use that. Well, now you can see few download options based on the computer version and architecture. If you don't know your computer architecture, click on start and search for system information. Here you go. Now you can see mine is a 64-bit PC. So in this case, I'll be downloading the first one. I suggest you to read this page. It has other fixing method also. As the download complete, hit open. The downloaded zip has the DLL file in it and a readme file. You can read that too. In order to move the DLL, you need to first open this PC. Then open your system drive. In my case, it is this local disk C. Okay, let's open it. Then Windows. And find a folder named system32. There it is. Then now click on the downloaded zip file. Drag the DLL file. And drop. I have already done this, so it is asking me to replace, and click on continue if it asks for administrator access. And finally, restart your computer. This is applicable if you are a 64-bit user. You need to open this PC one more time, then local disk C. Then Windows, and this time find a folder name syswow64. There it is. Drag the DLL and drop. I've already done this, so it is asking me to replace. Now job is done. And finally, restart your computer. Every computer are different, so if the problem still occurs, you can go and read the Microsoft forum. I'll put the link in the description as well. But I strongly suggest you to do something else, that is installing the Microsoft Visual C++. If you have the same problem or any other DLL file missing, just install it. Choose your Windows version. I'm choosing the 64-bit. Now the download has started. You can see the exe file. You can install it easily. And that's all. If you follow me step by step, you no longer have the problems left. Let me know if you have any questions and do not forget to like and subscribe. You can watch my other videos as well. Thank you for watching.